Hello there, and this following video talks about the concept of the transfer of Manchester United. And in this case we talk about the transfer of Frankie de Jong to United. And unfortunately the news isn't that great. There's recently have been rumors of Frankie de Jong coming to United, and Manchester United are yet to hold talks with Barcelona midfielder Frankie de Jong for fruitful talks. And it looks like in this January, the transfer wish would not be fruitful or materialized. Because, Barcelona midfielder Frankie de Jong over a move to Old Trafford, has been long waited for. But this might not just happen right now, according to Fabrizio Romano. So the Dutchman hasn't enjoyed, that well of a happiest of the times in Spain since he moved from Ajax to Barcelona. He has been struggling a lot under, the new, under Koeman. And with the Messi move, and all of that, De Jong has been linked with a move away from the Catalan giants in order to enjoy a fresh start, a fresh challenge, and get away from the current situation in Camp Nou. United have been tipped to make a move for the 24-year-old, but a fresh update has now been provided on the matter, and it's perhaps not what the fans Manchester United would be hoping for. Taking to Twitter on Thursday evening, Romano claimed in a 14-word verdict that a move to Old Trafford next month isn't yet on the cards. And as it is the case with PSG as well. De Jong is clearly one of the most outstanding players right now and is in very much demand. Everybody is looking for him, everybody wants to sign him, people are after him. And it's clear that, he has played really well and he has excelled with Barca. So the new Barcelona coach Xavi, it's obvious he wants De Jong to stay in the team, and he does not want to lose more star players. Though Barcelona is in a lot of debt right now, and they're having some problems, they don't want to lose their star players. Because the current manager Xavi has described him as an extraordinary footballer. Here is someone who could make an enormous difference with United midfield. Not only bring world-class quality on the ball, but also world-class dribbling ethics, and powerful, passing skills. De Jong has averaged 91.4% pass complete ratio. Only, this is only achieved by Jesse Lingard. Has a better tally for United, but from a tiny sample size. The combination of technical skill, reading of the game, and the physicality could make him as one of the perfect long-term replacement for someone like Paul Pogba, whose contract is on the verge of being finished. So let's admit it, that Paul Pogba's contract is almost being finished, and due to this reason he's having a lot of problems, getting used to the team, coming onto the team, replacing the team, and making, coming here and making a permanent impact on the midfield. He's not being able to do that, and it's highly unlikely whether he will be able to do that in the future or not. So it's very, very disappointing. And so what do you think about this fact? Look, what I think, I think about this is, United should definitely go for De Jong. But De Jong also has to, because if he's a player in Barcelona, if he makes a move to, United, that will be, a direct contradict to the legacy of Messi, maybe. That might be a case as well. He might be worried, he doesn't want to go to a club, and get close to Ronaldo. You don't want to do that. And that would be, that would be a big blow. And further, Fabrizio Romano has said that, United are trying to look for players. They are interested in, Frankie de Jong, but de Jong or Barcelona haven't made direct contacts with them yet. Bayern Munich are right now showing a lot of interest, Juventus as well, but, he's not interested to go to Man United. And why? I don't know. Maybe, that's not his preference. So according to, Fabrizio Romano, and according to various other sports outlets, worldwide news regarding soccer, De Jong, is not willing to go to a team with Ronaldo, Sancho, Fred, Greenwood and Maguire and others, Rashford. Maybe he feels, they're already packed with attack, they're packed with midfield and he won't have enough time. But I think that's wrong, because they're packed with attack, but they are not packed with midfield. And if Erik ten Hag comes along, as per different news sources across the world, soccer and soccer news say, then I'm quite sure he won't be having that problem. Manchester United haven't made any approaches to sign Frankie de Jong, and any January deal appears improbable. The Dutchman hasn't lived up to his price tag at FC Barcelona and appears a shadow of the player he was once expected to be. Even though the 24-year-old midfielder has shown some excellent performances in recent seasons, he has failed to make a significant impact on the Catalan club. The Netherlands international has been heavily linked with a move to Manchester United in recent times, but transfer expert Fabrizio Romano has said that a January move is implausible as the Red Devils haven't approached the Barcelona board to discuss the possible move. There are a lot of rumors about Manchester United, but at the moment there is nothing going on with the Manchester United. Nothing is expected to happen in the January transfer window for Frankie de Jong. So nothing is expected to happen, you know. There are no moves going on in the January, you know, window as per Fabrizio Romano, and there are no moves on the card. So it's highly unlikely that he will be making a move. He will be going, you know, some new place, you know. It's highly unlikely. The Italian football journalist added that Red Devils are explicitly looking for a defensive midfielder at this moment, and they don't have any plans to lure an attacking-minded midfielder like De Jong, as they already have an abundance of choices in the ranks. Barcelona are still struggling to cope up with the departure of the Lionel Messi in the summer, and if they let someone like De Jong go, I mean, it would be yet another bigger loss, because, you know, the manager Xavi has said he is an extraordinary footballer. But the main problem is De Jong hasn't showed any stellar performance this season. The player has only managed to bag one goal, two assists, I mean 19 appearances across all competition in the current campaign, and that is not very impressive. So the player has not been able to, you know, show that kind of a stellar performance, and with him not being able to do that, that is also quite saddening. So Manchester United currently have a lot of options in position. Paul Pogba, Bruno Fernandes and Donny van de Beek all are proven talents. Of course, matters could change when the likes of Paul Pogba decide to move out. I think Paul Pogba is going to move out, and it's better for him to move out because it's like a toxic relationship now. You know, you guys want to break up, it's not working, but you're too attached, you know, and you don't know what you're doing, you know, it's not going to work. It's just like a toxic relationship right now. So basically, yeah, so that's it. Seems, you know, new manager Ralf Rangnick has found out a favor Dutch midfielder Donny van der Beek to be useful, and thus United has not decided to sell him, and it has been said, you know, that he will be given ample, you know, amount of game time. So if you have somebody like van der Beek and Bruno Fernandes, you know, in the midfield, so I think bringing up another midfielder, you know, would not be useful right now immediately. What I think United should get, you know, I think is a brand new defender. A defender would be very, very useful right now for them, you know, absolutely useful. It would be very useful. They would get a new defender, let him play, let him set the game, let him set the rules, you know, bring him here, you know, get any new defender. And with that, I'll be talking about a new defender that Manchester United are targeting in the very next video, and you'll get to know it right now, because you know I give, you know, 100% authentic transfer news. So Frankie de Jong is not coming to Manchester United this January, but, you know, maybe in the future we will try harder for him. So that's the news, and, you know, stay with us, and thank you guys for coming, subscribing. You know, I'll try to give my best to give you new news on United. Till then, take care.